Hey everybody, it's Probably Red. So I just got done doing the announcement for what changes are going on in the channel. So I'm not going to talk about any of that here because there's a whole video dedicated to it. I did on my Undermine video talk about it a little bit. Let's jump into the draft. Okay, so let's see what's here. Okay, so here's some things I'm seeing from the beginning here. Var's favor is pretty decent. Let's see, prophesize is something I'm pretty fond of. I think I totally overrate it. Learn Herbalist is like a card I also probably overrate, but I still think is very good. I think Amber Oxide is probably better because you don't have to discard a card to get your sigil. You just get the sigil, but it costs one more. I think Sandstorm's Curve is probably unplayable. Yeah. Mantle of Justice is a bit not a good idea. I think like fixing this early is really great. So let's just go ahead and take the Amber Acolyte. This is okay removal, but you have to get Spark. So you have to be kind of ahead, which is kind of like, or be using like flyers, and it's double fires that kind of brings it down. Unmake is pretty good. I think it's better than Decay by a long shot. They're both fast spells, but this can kill two just for decimating. And if there's like a decimate synergy card that you have in the future, like that could be good. Yeah, I think Learned Herbalist is neat, but I think Amber Acolyte is very seriously good. Am I wrong? Am I wrong for rating Learned Herbalist over Amber Acolyte? I don't think so. I think I'm just going to go ahead and pick it. Feels like a comfortable pick. Oh my goodness. Okay, so here's a cool rare nobody took, but here is an amazing uncommon Twin Brood Sauropod. That just like totally caught my eye right from the start there. Cover Fire Marksman is also a good card. Blackguard Sidearm is also great, and Peacekeeper's Helm. Man, there's a lot of good cards in this pack. Wisdom Elders is takeable, but it pushed into Primal, Double Primal. Not exactly what we're looking for. Rampage is a decent card, but where we're really focused here, I think Peacekeeper's Helm might be a little bit better than Blackguard Sidearm. But that's like between these three. What does this do? Let's read it. Whenever you play a third spell in a turn, draw this from your void, and you could pay an extra two to make it a 5/2 weapon. It's not that bad. It's not that good. It's about in between. Like, it's not... What is it? Like, okay, so there's like the 4/3 weapon for four. This doesn't do much more than that. It's actually pretty bad looking at it, like, and compared to that card in Shadow. I just don't understand why it's so bad. There's no way we're playing three spells. That's why it's bad. Okay. Twin Brood Sauropod. We could stick to time. Have a great card. But we're missing out on these. Let's take it. Ooh, when you play your second unit, turn draw a card. Now, if we go really, really unit heavy, that could be... You could draw us, like, maybe three cards in a game. Yeah, it's worse than Wisdom of Elders. Yeah, we don't want that. Okay. So let's look elsewhere. This is something we 100% do not want. Wow. It's very bad, right? Am I crazy? Okay, so time is looking like it's drying up in this pack. Or not this pack, but this pick. There we go. Crownwatch Longsword's okay. Something amazing. There's some really bad cards in this pack. I might just take a seat or Stonescar Banner. I don't think Vault is good enough. I mean, having a relic might just matter. So, I mean, that's a possibility. A very speculative seat, though. Man, this is such a bad pack. I want to... Okay. So, I'm not trying to be facetious, but I am totally snipping this. I know it's the middle of a draft, but it's just really a funny thing to me. Okay, so we're going to minimize that. We're getting back into it. Hopefully that didn't show up at all on the, on anything. Yeah, we should be good. So we're continuing here. We're not taking the vault, are we? Wait, what could be good with vault? The cultists could be, like, if we do tokens. Okay, we're probably not going to run it. What else could we run? Seats, that's it. I know I've been saying the same thing, but it's like really the only thing that I can really think of right here. Maybe Roland's favor, Crownless Longsword. Let's take a speculative longsword here. Water of Life. Yeti Traditionalist isn't totally unplayable. It's not exactly good. Immortalizes, they would take us into time real quick. Now, if we take a vault of Praxis, I'd probably pick Submerged Titan. But, what does this do? Give one of your plus one additional plus additional plus one for each spell in your void. Does it count itself? Probably not. Does it count itself? That's probably just plus one. Man, that's pretty bad. Out of this, I'm thinking one of these three cards right here. I think I want the Immortalize. We're just gonna take a speculative Immortalize. What does this one do? Draw Sentinel or Ruck from the top five, discard the rest. Or in exactly these colors. I still don't think it's a good card though. I'm not saying it's bad, it's just not like something I'm very fond of personally. I think we could probably just take the insignia. Yeah. I mean, Granite Acolyte's a pretty good card. I mean, at 3 cost 4 and 1, they could also just be putting a weapon on another unit. But that would be our fourth color, like that we'd be picking. Let's take this insignia, which would be our fourth color too, but you know. Okay, so that kills an attachment and deals damage. I think that's worth just taking to be in the deck. It's better than Decay. Might be better than Unmake. Maybe not. There's so much good stuff in this pack. Yeah, like this is freaking fantastic. That's not very good. These are good. These aren't great, I guess is a better way to put it in my eyes for this build. These five cards are all runnable. I think Draconic Ire is kind of calling my name just because it's cool that it's a rare and it got passed and it's better than Decay. I think that's what like is making me go crazy for it. Kill a four cost or more, a four attack or more, dispel and unit respectively. Blackguard Sidearm looks pretty good here for kind of a Zenny thing. I'm a bit perplexed about where I should go here. Yeah, this is not happening, right? There'll be three factions. Let's go Blackguard Sidearm. I think it's a lot safer than Draconic Ire. Praxis Banner. I'm gonna try to avoid this stuff if I can. It's looking like I kind of have to pick something though. Let's take a speculative banner because I don't think we're missing too much. Not taking a five through the overwhelm. Prophesize would be a lot better with that four drop, but like I gotta let it go. I gotta let it go. I mean, Wandering Forge would be pretty good with that too. I think we should just take the basing guide here, right? I'm crazy. Out of this pack, like maybe the Prophesize is more likely to get ran. Let's just take it. Okay. Runic Protector, I'm not super sure about that card. Living Mountain's a good card, and Lynrai Vandal may come up. I think Lynrai Vandal's our card here. Wanderlust Kirin, I think that's not bad. Is this any good? Four damage to an enemy, that's great. Put one of your units in your understanding to gain its health, no. And to get an enemy spell, fine. For three factions, doesn't seem that great. But this late, I think we just take it, right? I'm just very low on Submerged Titan. And I'm not super high on Wanderlust Kirin. At two costs with two factions. No, let's just take this. Three for three factions. Anyways, we'll take the Wisdom here. Oh, we'll take the Bandit's Flail, right? Now comparing this to Phoenix's Hammer. It gets plus one for plus one attack or damage attack. For two cost with all those other abilities. Then you could pay two more to give it another plus one attack. That's really bad. That makes this look better, which is probably not a good thing. Yeah, we don't want double fat, but we'll take the shadow. And then the gibbering. Anyways, condemn. That's like better than Vara's Favor, potentially. You get a gibbering jackal. Okay. Rage probably ain't gonna make it. Unfamiliar Interloper, something we'll keep an eye on. Bladecrafter is a possibility. Not exactly like 100% what we're going for here. Token could make it. What else? Waystone Gate. Yeah, I didn't even notice that yet. But we're 100% taking Waystone Gate out of this entire pack. It is like, other than maybe this, like, especially with the direction we're going, like, okay, wait a minute. I still think Waystone Gate's better, right? Just take it. Crack the Earth. Okay, Touch of Battles. That's all right. Defile's pretty good. That's a strong card. Kill any 3 cost. Maybe it's better in Constructed, though. Of course, Brood of Aramoth's a really well-statted unit. Only problem is the double Primal. We're in Primal. It's not looking like Justice is very open. Primal and Fire are something I could, like, delve into. Book Club Yeti's just good. It's a lot more to think about in this pack. I think we could just take the kill spell. This a possibility? Cursing units. I remember this. I messed up by taking this thing. It just kills units, but that's not the case. That would be very, very powerful, but it's not what it does. So, Touch of Battle, Crack the Earth, Defile, or maybe Contaminating Ritual if I had some Exalted stuff. Not sure. Then I could give one of my Twin Brood Sauropods Contaminating Ritual. That sounds pretty good. Okay. We get 5 costs. I could just, I don't know. I think I'm way, way, way into. It's the blue. The blue gem gets me. Okay, one thing I heard on the Eternal Journey podcast today, I was listening to it. I need to have a plan. This is the farthest away I think I've ever been from a plan. I think we could just cut that for now. Right now we're trying to get to Twin Brood Sauropod. We might be playing Primal. A lot of this is dedicated to fixing. This is just like be able to like get if we could just draw Twin Brood Sauropod out, oh, that'd be awesome. Making some of our units a little bit harder to like. I don't think that's getting ran either. So we don't have too much yet. Just getting sigils. We need some like stuff to kill stuff, like just it's gonna be good against flyers. It's good with immortalize. The question is it good enough in this format, like for what it does? It's a lot of stuff it kills. It's better than Bar's favor, I think, and that makes it runnable. It's like better than Seer, possibly. About on par with Seer, I would say. And that makes it very, like, it changes things a lot. Let's take it. I'm just trying to figure out the mindset that I have to, like, take it. Now, this card, just for being able to get one of two sigils, is worth it. Now, if we had all three, that could be interesting. I mean, we could dip into Justice, but I don't know. I mean, Edge of Prophecy is a very good card. I just have been lower on it in this version of the format. So this pack, let's look. I mean, we could pick Switchblade, Deadeye. This one do? No. I mean, Fanatical Stranger is a possibility. We could take Token of Purpose for that Primal if we really wanted to, but no. I think Destruction Chance, honestly, the card we're looking for. I don't know if this is getting nerfed yet. Oh no, this isn't the one that's getting nerfed. I'm thinking the one that costs less if you cast a spell this turn. Yeah, it's a different card. I'm glad Dead Sea Flame's not getting nerfed. I like that card a lot. Posture Reflection isn't going to be picked, so it's really between Destruction Chant and Dancing Flame here. Maybe Assault Shield. We'll take the Destruction Chant. I'm not super high on Yojimba. I think it's a neat design for a card. I just don't think it's good in this format. mean, it's a 0-6, so that's not bad. I mean, it's not horrible. You killed your max in power, my hands and draw two cards. No, if it just draws two cards, that's amazing. It's good in a deck that you can give him Aegis or her, him. I think it's a him. Doesn't matter. It's okay. Triumphant Return. A little bit more synergy with Twin Brood Sword Farm. We need units. Got a lot of three drops too. So we're primarily Time and Shadow currently, so that's what we're trying to stick to. And then the next thing we could probably go is Primal from the looks of it. Or Fire. I don't think we're taking Yeti Cookmaster. Justice looks like really good in this pack. Siege Provision is probably the card I should be taking. I'm going to take the Triumph Return just to see where it's going. Here's another Justice card, but other than that, it's pretty empty. Shugo's Hook Sword is pretty decent. I think it's, in a lot of ways, in this format, better than Edge of Prophecy. Because you could stick to, in this case, it would put us to a third faction, but it's not an 100% thing. But it kind of is in this case. Platinum Kieran's not bad. Extra maximum power. If we have stuff that Relic matters, that could help. I think we take the Hook Sword, though. It's just very strong. It's going to kind of push us in the direction of Primal, or not Primal, Fire, too. Now, Fear Tracker is a huge reason to be in Shadow. So we're almost 100% going to take that. And yes, nothing else is really differing that thought process for me. Entrance Cultist isn't bad, but I think I want Burning Cordric more. But now we're really getting to the point where we're going very far. Well, you know, maybe we could have Time as a splash at this point, though. Maybe I'm crazy, but I think we can focus more on Fire. Even though our fixing is in Time, which is kind of problematic. I mean, the other option is Fel Rock's Infiltrator, and that's Shadow Shadow. And this is just a better card, in my opinion. Maybe I'm giving it too much credit, but I think it's still pretty good. You can't block very well once you start attacking with it. That's a problem. This does ping. We do have a couple weapons, so... You know, I think I actually will take the Felrox Infiltrator. Okay, Containment Ritual is a possibility, I suppose. Verno Zealot's not bad. I'll take that over Contaminating Ritual. Wow, this is a pretty nice pack. Do we want this? It's not a relic, open just a weapon, so we can get black card sidearm. That's great. This is Fire and Shadow, which is pretty decent. Let's take the Blade Crafter here. That's perfect. We're just gonna take that right now. Humbugness is okay. This leader's pretty bad for us. And at this point, Strange Ally is very good. So let's take out all the Primal real quick. That's just something I'm not interested in anymore for this. I got some decent fixing. So what are we primarily? Yeah, Fire is definitely our third faction. But I think every single, or like the majority of the cards are double fires, so that's kind of a problem. I don't think I can afford to take Strange Ally here. It's just not going to be worth it. Rectifier is very strong, but it's another double influence card. Sorcery Jedi is okay. Do we have the Cultist? We didn't take the Cultist, so that makes it just a bit more worse. It's a tad bit worse. I don't know. Okay, so we could take the token. I don't think that's gonna happen. Is it better than Fire? The Strange Ally? No. We'll take Rectifier. Kind of punish, man. Justice just seems really good. Interloper might help. Plate Mill's okay, but not something we could pick. I think I'll take the Interloper. Magnificent Stranger. Wow, Grave Watching Ancestor. We need more 2-drops, so I think Magnificent Stranger is kind of perfect here. Yeah, we're gonna take that. I feel like the all these got like boosted for rare, because I've been seeing a lot of them in these packs. Magnificent Stranger again seems great. Nothing else is super standing out to me in our factions. Tokens okay. Shardbinder is really good. Even though there's maybe one thing it triggers. It's just well statted, and that one synergy as is worth it. But then of course there's Aramoth's Machinations, and I think that's just busted. Okay amount, well not an okay amount, a pretty low amount of 2-drops, but a good amount of 3-drops. So we just need to, oh man, this is hard when they're both in the same pack. And I think for that reason I'm taking the Shardbinder. Maybe I'm crazy, but yeah, I think I'm crazy. But I just, wow. Okay, Felrock Infiltrator, I don't want another 3-drop that's double faction influence. I think I want the token. Maybe I'm going too ham on the fixing here. I mean, I might be. Triumphant Return's okay, but we already have 2 return effects. Let's go for this. Pack Conjuring's okay. It's runnable. Decimate Invoke's okay. It's one of the lesser of the Conjurings, I believe. But I don't think it's unplayable. Okay, so we got good old Skeletal Dragon. That's not bad. I remember like one of the first decks I built for like the preview was Skeletal Dragon and the Pack Conjuring, like the kind of like graveyard effects, and I had like 3 of each, I think. I don't think it's one I posted, but it was pretty bad, honestly. So I mean, I want to take this, but at the same time I'm kind of apprehensive, to be honest. But I'm gonna take it because there's nothing else here. Might take in another Inferno Zealot. That pledge is pretty good. Still not fond of Contaminating Ritual enough to take it over Inferno Zealot. We'll take a Dive Bomb and a Siege Provisions. Man, I think Justice was super open. Holy mackerel. I think it's too late to switch though. We got some pretty good stuff with what we're doing here. Proselytize is not the card that I want. And probably Club's not 100% bad. Golem Press is actually really good. Might be a bit busted. I don't think we can get rid of like the Waystone Gate and the Twin Board Sauropod and the Magnificent Stranger. Like, it's just so good. But maybe Fear Tracker, Blackguard Sidearm, Defile, Immortalize. Wow, that's pretty good too. And then Fire, the Hook Sword, the Zealots, Blade Crafter. I think we could probably get rid of the Fire. It's a possibility, but man, we got those Tokens of Destruction. Like, we're gonna okay set up with Fire. We're gonna try to avoid Fire as much as possible, even though they got a couple doubles. Why not run Blade Crafter? I don't know yet. Learner of Bliss is more fixing. This is pretty solid. I like the Cover Fire Marksman. We have a lot of 5-drops though. Another Immortalize. We don't really need it. We could get a 4/4, 4/2 for 4. I don't want the Cover Fire Marksman. Slay. Golly, if we were in Justice right now. Even Rogan's Disciple's okay. Blackguard Sidearm is pretty good. The Vandal's okay. I think we wouldn't mind another sidearm, right? Got a couple units in here that would really want it. Fixing does help, but I'm taking the sidearm. Man, that slay. I just like, maybe I should just take it. But I don't know. I don't know about the last minute swapping here. Because I think I read some signals wrong, but ooh, Smuggler's Dash. Really good. It's worse than Aramoth's Machinations. But still pretty good. I think I should take the Evangel here, right? If I'm going to take Evangel, though, it should probably be Gyarados Evangel. Or do we want it to be on our splash? like the double damage dealer. Our Nurbless, like, we got a lot here. Like, this is a pretty good pack. Grodov's Evangel or Shopka Evangel? I think the Shopka Evangel is better between the two. Wormson's okay. How many spells we got? We got six spells. I don't know, though. I'd rather have a Magma Javelin, even though it's... Wait a minute. Berserk, attacks, gives you power. Okay, I think I like the Rusty Grin Emotive over Magma Javelin. No, we don't have any 4-drops. We could use that to pretty good effect. How many... We got... two relics. One of them is the giant sword. No, I don't think consuming greed is going in this deck. I really like Rusty Grin Emotive, but I think we take it. Honestly, I think we take it. Pox's banner is pretty good. Just for game, it's pretty good too. But let's take the banner. Take a Stone Scar banner now. Horn of Plenty is really good. We don't have too many units. Yeah, we got a good bit of units. Hmm. You play a spell. That's not bad. That, Stranger? Yeah, I think I want that over the Stonescape Banner, but do I want it over Horn of Plenty? Maybe I'm crazy, but I want the Stonescape Stranger more than the Horn of Plenty here. Reckless Combatant isn't terrible. I think Vine Pillar Creeper is probably better. Do we have the means to do that? Is it any attachment? Spell and attachment. Okay. That could happen. It's possible. It's only one time, like temporary though. I'll take it. But cost 4/4 is not like ridiculously bad. I like Ornamental Daggers over Wormstone. Maybe I'm crazy. We'll take Combatant now. Take this Titan. Cruelty, because it's more likely to get ran between the two, but it's not getting ran. Because I'm not gonna make a micro splash for double primal. Let's get this thing chopped to bits real quick. I think our fixing is phenomenal. We're gonna get rid of all the primal first. That's what we're getting out first. And then let's see where we sit. We want, yeah, about 17 power. So we only have 3 cuts. That is insanity. We probably want them to be 3-drops if possible, but let's look at everything. So I know there's gotta be some bad cards in here. Maybe not though. So far, yeah, I could probably cut that and that. Those are 3-drops we don't want, and we'll probably cut that for now. And then everything else so far, I'm not super fond of all the double. Yeah, we got a lot of double. But I mean, it's honestly a very even split. It's just gonna be hard to cast up sometimes. That's some power. And I think this is phenomenal, phenomenal, phenomenal. This is so good. This is crazy. I think this can do stuff. I'm excited about this. Let's jump right into it. Let's clear this up real quick. Let's jump into it. First game up against Shimra. Ooh, we can run this. We can run this. We can get our set. We can get Shadow or Second Time, depending on what goes on. We need... No, we don't. Yeah. We can get, we can go Second Time to start and get our Shadow out in a minute. That'll be good. Okie dokie. So, Shimura's playing some fire action. Let's go with this. And then we'll go with our Second Time to be able to get out a Humbug Nest to push in the sky. We'll see what happens. We're kind of like feeling out like what's going on. We do want some Shadow. Do definitely want some Shadow. And there we go. That's perfect. So we could get double fire. I don't know if we want it. I think we want the double Shadow first. Let's go with fire next. So we just have 3-drops galore in this deck and in this hand. This is definitely a good sample of what the deck looks like. I like that we have 3-faction split down the middle. Like, this is a true 3-faction deck. Let's see if it does good work. Let's see if it does good work. Okay. So, let's go Second Time. Yeah. We'll drop this down here. Silence this. 2/4 is a lot less threatening to us. We want to get up to Inferno Titan or Inferno Zealot and give it the Black Arts item because it's very removable, but it's very good. So we just place as many units as we can. Hopefully they remove stuff. Okay, that's not great for our game plan here. That's not great at all. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drop that, block it, drop something. You know, we gotta figure it out. That sounds that. How much does it cost? 2? Not a great way to spend a turn. Not a great way to spend the turn. Do we just play the sigil, right? Where's the rewind button? We'll see the whole replay. I know this is crazy that I'm doing this. Which was the time? Like, I was very curious. Oh yeah, okay, we play the sigil. See? I'm crazy. So we're gonna silence that. So that doesn't just die. And then we're gonna take 5 damage. Go to 15. It's worth it. See, that replay feature is useful. You can also press the R key on computers. Not sure if the replay feature exists on mobile. So next turn we can drop the Ambrogolite, and then we have a 2-drop. We really need to just get rid of, or get some blocker out. This deck is very aggressively statted, which is kind of like not a good thing for us. Okay. 2/2 double damage is pretty good, right? Let's go ahead, we're gonna do the thing. We need Shadow. We need Fire. Let's go Shadow first. We got a 2/1 blocker for that 3/2 Yeti Cookmaster that we can take out. It's going pretty good so far. Okay. What's going on, Shimra? Ooh, Flame Bathe Reformation. Exalted. Do we chump block? I don't think a chump block, for sure. Okay, this is going pretty badly, right? Am I crazy? Yeah, this is going pretty badly. Let's drop our dreams of, could give this double damage. That's not going to help us, is it? Oh my gosh, we could get a crazy turn off, couldn't we? It's too much. Maybe they won't attack if we drop this? And then if they do attack, we just kind of have to block. Being a bit hasty, but we can next turn, like, just deal 16 damage. That'd be pretty cool. It could be 20 damage. Okay. Now we're. Dude, this hand is nuts, but we have to. We need time in general. We give this -8. Yeah, let's do that. We're gonna decimate. We're going crazy. And out of these three, let's go with the bouncer. Don't want to face the charge unit. We're not gonna let them come in charging. It's not gonna happen. Because it could be a Vandal. Vandal's real easy. Now anything could charge. Okay. So we need to play another blocker, right? Did we just get Dark Return? Did we try to just get a combo off? Because, like, we're at a point where we have to get something going. Don't like sacrifice. Do not sacrifice. Overwhelm? Just get overwhelmed. Okay, good. Okay, so now got some cool possibilities here. We can start by giving this double damage, but we also could start by giving the Black Art sidearm and swinging in. We might just remove it, but this is getting pretty crazy. So yeah, we'll just chump block here. What do you got? Rampage? Attack. In turn, I want to go Humbug's Nest. I want to surprise them so they can't just remove it at sorcery speed. Because that would be very bad for us. Dropping this. Okay. So far, this is going amazing. Ugh. Oh, you're kidding. Good game. Well played with the hammer hand. Dang, they wrecked us. All right, we're going up against Dracula. Now this, these two cards and these three, and these four, this is already really good. Got a little bit of late game action if we need it. I'd like to get some more like playables and not get this just auto removed, but this is looking pretty good. We could be selective with ornamental daggers and wait until they like put a threat out that like can't get past without playing them, or we could just play them. Up to us. That's pretty threatening. We'll take the damage. Ooh, they double the damage. It's not good. They didn't double damage. That would have been ridiculous. That would be crazy. I don't think that was the best card for you to pick. You could just the sigil would have been better. Maybe they have some life force in there? I'm not sure. Just go for it. Hopefully they didn't take remover. So we're getting towards the possibility of an Inferno Zealot. That would be nice. Oh, I don't like Wormstone. Okay, now I can see a reason for you to be running the Waters of Life. It's more spells. That's awesome. So even though we are way behind in health and they're potentially going to get a 7-7, we are pushing as hard as we can to get there. We are just struggling to do as much damage as possible. Please don't have a spell. Spark is good for us. Kind of good for us. Okay. So let's see what we got here. Okay. So there is a very high potential for us to lose this turn. If they like rally or something crazy. Okay, no, they just made a lot of cultists. Not good news. Oh, we're blocking that. Yeah, we'll trade. Probably should trade away longer because that never even was a thing that possibly could have happened. But, you know. We're in a 9 turn block now. Less because of that. Oh. This is such a bad situation. This is very bad. Even if we, like, oh my gosh. We'll have to chump here. Oh my gosh. Is this gonna be a 0-3? Just getting her butt handed to me. I thought the deck was good. I feel like it's good. But man, we're getting our butt handed to us. Okay. At least we get to go out in style. We'll play there for that. I don't notice that. We're up against Mountain Mouth Music. Alright, let's go ahead and redraw this one. We need time. And this is better. This is a lot better, I feel like. We should probably pledge here, right? Nah, we can go without pledging. Let's go practice banner first. So the turn to play this fire sigil completed. Probably end up wanting to use that for shadow, or just like have it to be able to choose what we get. Stranger. Fervent Siphoner. A player discards a card. This gets plus one. Okay. Okay. That's pretty solid. The Exalted. I think we do want double time. We'll go ahead and silence this. Now they double block, they'll kill my Mag Stranger, but I'll get the reduction off that and kill their 1-2. Yeah, maybe not the best. Now they have the board. So next we need Shadow. Still getting there for a little bit of damage. Okay, okay. I'll grab a Shadow Sigil. We'll block that Fanatical Stranger with our Rectifier. Or we could double block and kill the Bold Adventurer stats over there. I don't think that's what we're gonna do though. It's not our plan. That is a really good to see. I'm not even being sarcastic. Like, that is fantastic. Alright, so let's go here. I don't know if we really want to silence. Our magic. Yeah. We'll still silence this anyway, so we have the extra. We have the ability to do that. So next, Inferno Zealot and Marksman are great. All that we have to curse unit. Sacrifices an uncursed unit of their choice that discards cards equal to the unit's attack. Let's go ahead and get rid of Magnus Stranger, however strange it may seem. No. We'll take it. We would love to be able to get that card selection. I guess we'll go with a third time. Swing for one. Hope they don't remove, right? Let's go for it. Doubling down on the Zealot is pretty fantastic, but having this backup plan is not bad either. The speaker approaches. Okay. So let's go ahead and do double damage. So at least it's a big burst of damage, and we kill something. They block multiple units, it's even more damage. It's pretty solid. I think that was worth it. Plus we get a 4-2, essentially. Let's good value. Yeah, I really, really am fond of Cover Fire Marksman. I think this deck deserves more than a 0-3. I think it can go far. It's got so much potential, it's just so strong. Next turn we get Sugar's Extort. I think we really need to kill that 2-3 ASAP. My dad. That's not good, but... So we can get that. We need to do this though. Kill that before it gets too strong. And then perhaps block this. We're gonna chump block it. Yeah, so it can't do its thing. And then we'll kill it with the actual weapon. And get to draw a card from the top five of their deck. This will work out. I wonder if it'll come back as a 0-4 no matter what. Like, even if I reduce its stats. How does it work? It's always gonna be that. It's a token. Okay. So what we could do... Minus 8 is what's getting us. Dang it. Does something with a lot of health. Okay, so we could swing 4, 5 damage. Kill this. Get a chump. Take a card off the top. Okay. Echoing. Do we get the echo? Anyways, it doesn't matter. What's not what we're looking for here? Deadly's not bad. Deadly's pretty good. And then let's go. Do we need to return? We gotta hurry. Okay. Shard Binder would have been a good one. Dang it, we should have went Shard Binder. So they can most assuredly activate that. One of the like sneakily convenient things that's going on here is I just pulled that unit out so Pot Conjuring can give us a damage boost. If we use it on different units. Well, if we'd use it, it wouldn't. Okay, yeah. Never mind. So that is a possible thing that could happen. I wonder what they can get done. We're gonna block very defensively if they do decide to attack. All they need is 4 damage. We're done. They've got a combat trick, we're done because they have unblockable, depending on the card. Okay, cool. Let's go all out. Okay, that's game. Well played, not enough music. Good game. Okay, what we got there. We're up against Frumious Scrump. Can we keep this? It's very close. Could really get stuck in a spot here. But if not, we can really do some good work. And get unfamiliar interloper out with time and hope in time. Oh, Severin's coming back, I believe. I think I've seen his. Oh, I don't want to spoil anything. People don't want to see spoilers. So we'll see. Something. Oh, we have one. Good. We're good. Never mind. So now we just need time. Our match is unbroken. Push for some damage. So that's a problem we have to deal with quickly. Our match is so we're pushing pretty good so far. That could cause us some issues. Safe travels. Double reduction. That's pretty good. All right. So we're getting a pretty decent board state. They do have more cards in hand, though. That's a problem. Ooh. Is it permanent? No, it is permanent. I don't really want that. I could get a Magnificent Stranger and make it a 4 or 5. Sure, let's see. Okay. You can get back the Amber Acolyte. That's actually really good. Safe traps. You now get a Fire Sigil. Drop it. Get this. I guess get another one. So die anyways, might as well. Only problem is this keeps going on after it's dead. Swing with a possibility of 8. Okay, very good. That is very awesome. Oh, they lose if they do that. My dad. Well played for me. Yeah, maybe I was BMing my plan to everything, but I mean, I don't know. I wanted to see what I could do. I was excited. There's a char. So, let's see, bronze bicker. I don't like the sand. Too powery. Better. Better. Let's go with. This is a lot of big starting hand. Let's start with fire. Okay. So, this deck, like. They were saying on Eternal Journey, definitely. I misplayed. Wow, isn't that interesting? Has a plan, you know? Like, we get out units, Voltron them up, and then boom. Let's do that. 4-3 of the overall. Dang it. Every scrap. Decimate. Even though we're looking for maximum power. Let's do this. Get the killer shade. And get a sigil. This is going very well. We all right. Okay. Let's get a weapon of our choice. Got the first sidearm for now. Wow, we should have played the ornamental daggers. Oh my gosh. Is that a quick draw? Discard two cards. That. And honestly, that for now. So you're really solid. How much do I have to pay? Six? No, we'll just take the damage. I dislike the mastery effect you got, but there's no flying units and a big deal. Both. Try to push some damage of our own there. We do have the possibility of triumph of return, so that's pretty good. Wow. Drawing cards. It's very bad for us. Okay. Let's go ahead. Double damage shift. So, I mean, we are taking a lot of heavy damage here, but the bright side is we are retaliating very well. We survived. Play this turn, yes. Oh, this is bad. think we chump block the ground unit. Dang, they got a lot of stuff going on. Oh, Shardbinder. Kind of a pickle. I think we silence the hookjaw. We sing for 8. So I think if they do attack, we double block here. Trying to kill that unit if possible. Because a 4-6 berserk is nothing to shrug at. Okay. Get that going. Keep the sails an 8-8. That's pretty good. We're very low on health, but I think we're honestly in a pretty good position. Look at that. It's dead. They destroyed Shardbinder. But we have other stuff. We have other things. That is not good. Just drawing them card after card. Good game. Well played, Bronze Bicker. If you like the video, go ahead and click that thumbs up button. And subscribe to the channel if you want to see more draft content like this. We're getting really close to the preview draft for the coming up set, Argent Depths. So please go ahead and stay tuned for that. It's going to be awesome. Should be coming out this Friday, like the video at least. Thank you so much and have a great day.